I say to you again, Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
It is a very joyful day we celebrate, a time of fulfillment, a time of the fulfillment of the promise of Jesus. If I be lifted up, I will draw everyone to myself. His death and burial, which we have celebrated, is not the final part of this story. It is the tomb with the stone rolled away. His having said to us, greater love no one had than he lay down his life for his friends. Jesus, in his incarnation, has become one with all of humanity and became the source of life and fulfillment for all of us. We know just a few days ago, we heard him saying to the apostles, I have life because of the Father. And just as I have that life because of the Father, you will have life because of me. Abide in my love. Abide in my agape, that all-embracing love of the Father. I am the vine. You are the branches. Live on in me. What Jesus has done for us in his death and in his burial and his resurrection, he has won for us the power to be in the Father and in the Son and in the Holy Spirit. His life, the life of the Father, permeates the life of each one of us throughout the whole world, every person, giving to him or her meaning. He had asked the Father, sanctify me, make me holy, put my life all together so that I may assist my brothers and sisters in putting their lives together. When Paul began to speak about what Jesus had done, what was the meaning of all of this, he said, praise be the Lord and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has bestowed upon us every grace in the heavens. It has been his gracious will to do so. What he has made possible through his death and resurrection is that we might have life and have it to the full as he promised us. But we must constantly undergo his coming into our life in a personal way and make Jesus someone personal in our lives so that his life will have meaning in our life, that he will be the source of our joy, he will be the source of our life, and that we will celebrate Easter not just on this Sunday morning, but every day of our life in order that we might do that. Let us offer this prayer for all of us and for the church and all the people of God throughout the world. Oh, let the Son of God enfold you with his Spirit and his love. Let him fill your heart and satisfy your soul. Oh, let him have the things that hold you, and his Spirit like a dove will descend upon your life and make you whole. Jesus, oh Jesus, come and fill your land. Come and fill.